I got my everything.
Get the bag, King Walker.
Yeah, whole lot of everything. Pinky wing look like a red and ring. Riding my McLaren Spider, smoking on that Mary Jane. If it ain't no Fendi belt, I put it on your membrane. My little niggas insane, them little niggas loco. Please, I got 10 watches, you better watch your hoe, bro. Bitch, I'm back to ballin', but trickin' is a no-no. Don't spin with your...
So there was a day where you would drive past this neighborhood, and you would see just an empty lot with no structure, with no form, with nothing, just an empty lot, grass. Now, you could actually see one of the best modern homes that has ever been built in the whole wide fucking world. And look at it come together. Nice retaining walls, stucco. Man. Dreams come true, only if you work for them. People these days, they want to just dabble in all these different little things instead of actually sticking to one thing, making it work, go through the boring process, persevere through it, and make it fucking happen. I've been in the real estate business for 5 years now, and it's not even a long time, but it always shows the character of a person when he's capable of being in something for the long haul, right? Not just looking to dabble here. Oh, this is taking longer than what I thought, so I'm gonna try this. Or, oh, this isn't being as fruitful as I thought from the very beginning, so I'm gonna do fucking five different things at all at once, versus mastering that one thing that's going to bring you a shit ton of money, shit ton of experiences, shit ton of connections, bigger network, and ultimately a bigger net worth, because your network is your net worth, right? And that's very true. Stick to fucking one thing, grow it, scale it, build systems, and then if you want to go into something else, cool. Right now, everybody's just trying one thing. It's like starting a race, realizing that you actually have to get through the finish line, and it's going to take you a couple of laps, and then after the first lap, it's like, oh, well, I want to do something else. I want to do something that's shorter. And then starting another race and realizing that it's going to take you a couple laps. And then in the middle of the first lap, oh, well, you know, this is taking a little bit longer. Or I didn't like the way that this person talked to me, so I'm going to start this other race. No, stick to that one race. Commit to it. See it through. Give it all you got. And then, if it doesn't work out, then at least you know that you gave it all you fucking have. People these days, they just want to half-ass things and expect them to get the results because they're so used to seeing people on Instagram getting fucking rich and flashing these Lambos and flashing this and flashing that. It's like, bro, you don't really know how these people are living. You don't really know what these people are paying for and what they're not paying for, what they own, what they don't own. Like, stick to your process, focus on your lane, expand that lane, grow that lane, water that seed, grow it into a beautiful garden, focus on that, focus on anybody else, what everybody else is doing. Oh, this guy just made $1 million and I'm over here still making calls and not making shit. Listen, focus on your race. Instead of being distracted as to what everybody else is doing, you can be focused as to what you have to do to become better at that thing that's ultimately probably going to be more profitable and more fruitful than this other guy that's just maybe won the fucking lottery for all you fucking know. And now is trying to create something out of it by saying, oh, I'm this guy that did this thing. And meanwhile, there's really no substance behind how he made that money. You never fucking know. Stop assuming shit. Stop being distracted by other people. Focus on what the fuck you have to do. And if you stay in it for long enough and you're serious about it, in the end, you will win. Hell of a way to start a Friday with an accepted offer, isn't it, Johnny?
Hell yeah, it's a great way to start the weekend.
Yep, so the offer is officially accepted. You can go ahead and let your clients know. I'm happy to do this deal with you, brother. Let's get this shit to the finish line.
Hell yeah.
closing down. A million more to go. If you ain't closing deals, I don't want to talk to you. Money talks. Bullshit walks. Fuck, park their fucking car this close to me.
Are you filming this whole process? What's going on in the gym?
Everything, bro.
Alright, cool.
Yeah, bro. Let us know when you're going to the bathroom.
Alright, park.
Getting ready for the national BFP event. If you're hearing about it, you already missed it.
Yeah.
Other devices, top G. Who the fuck? It's a Matrix attack. Don't buy the hype. Now we're talking.
Right. Let's fucking go! Right here.
I'm gonna Draco. Listen, Clayco's.
Yeah, right.
Let's go.
Let's go! Man, it's eating them! Made for this shit.
Right here.
Oh yeah, Johnny.
Oh, Johnny!
Yeah. Johnny really out here!
Hey.
Oh!
Yeah.
Johnny TYB just set, bro.
Woo!
That's it. Johnny, what the fuck? Get back down there! Johnny,
yo,
keep going!
That motherfucker was shot at Chico for the burgers!
Nine. Come on! Your little brother's watching you! Let's go!
Let's go! Chess! Yeah, he's dead. That's it. That's it, Johnny's initiated.
Open up, Nate on the ground.
Let's go, baby.
Let's fucking go. Let's go, Nate. Let's
fucking
go, baby.
Up.
Down.
That's it. There's another one in the tank. Let's go!
Oh, there we go.
Go out, T.
Let's go!
Who's up next?
You resurrected!
That's it.
Learn some moves.
Jose, did you speak to that guy? I need to worry about it, bro. Stop talking about
it.
Yo, bro, how come
you don't dance?
Bro, Vinny's a fucking competitor.
Bro, how come you don't dance, though? How come you don't dance, though? I want
to
know.
Because I make money moves, motherfucker. I'm too busy to fucking dance with your bitch-ass bitch.
Mess right now. Don't look at me.
Yo, bro, why are you trying to get naked for me?
Relax.
Okay? Why are you trying to get naked for me, bro?
Why are you being so loud, bro? There's people here. Trying to pay me?
Bro,
you
got the pants on
fire. Hey.
What are
you doing?
His elite gonna fall out over here.
Relax. Come on. Tuck it back in your sock. What do you want to say?
Yeah. How much we gotta pay him? Oh, shit.
Yo, that's actually hilarious, bro. That's funny.
Transformation of being around Jose and especially meeting Nathan today, man. It's been awesome. They share some awesome business advice that I'm looking to implement in my own business. So I'm just excited, man. I'm fucking excited. That's all I can say, man. You should come through. Whoever's watching this, come to the next event. You won't regret it.
Got to reconnect my brothers. I got to share valuable experiences with them. Got to meet new people, network. And this is what it's all about. Family. Elevating.
My main takeaway that I got from them is success leaves clues behind. And the same struggles that people go through that are successful, other people that are also successful can also relate to, since I'm in real estate. And since sales is a cutthroat business, taught me and helped me to have that aggression, inner aggression, to be able to go out there and persevere through the no's that I get, the fuck yous that people tell me, and it just helps a lot, man.
It was a phenomenal event. Made a lot of realizations about life and about business and the mindset that it takes to become great. If you resonate with this and you want to be the person that elevates in life, come out to an event like this. Don't hesitate.
Money calling, told I gotta go. I'm back to ballin', I've been on the low. Yeah, a couple $1 million just made off the road. Nah, I ain't from the D, but this shit on the flow. Yeah. Any niggas, they can't fuck with me. Wanna give a shout out to my Nina, yeah, she stuck with me. You can go ask any one of these hoes, it ain't no cuffin' me. Mr. Glock, Mr. Get Shit Done, and I'm sucker free, bitch.